4th of July, we went out as Miisions of Love, and we ministered on the lakefront. I didn't know God gave us a mission there, but He gave us a mission. It was a mission of hope. Out there, we saw a halfway house full of people. There was about 20 people there at this halfway house. There had been situations where they were locked with drugs, alcohol, had been in the big house, but in a sense, they were still locked up because they were being regulated by what they had to do. And Miisions of Love was there, that's us. And I didn't know God told us to give us them some hope. Hope was given in the form of being treated like regular people. They weren't looked at people that owed money. They weren't looked at people that were in jail. They weren't looked at as someone who was hooked on drugs or alcohol. They were looked at as regular people. And I saw people there that had problems dancing with kids. People who didn't know other people were enjoying their company. You see, they needed that hope because one man went up to me and said, I will never forget this 4th of July for the rest of my life. You see, God has a way of giving you hope, but you have to be open to that hope. You can't say that all is lost and I give up now. You have to say, God is looking at you right now. Let me read you out of the Word of what He says. And there's another word for hope. It's called love. You see, you look in the Word, and love is called charity in the King James Version. But let me read you something. Love is patient and kind. Love does not envy or boast. It's not arrogant or crude. It doesn't insist on its own way. It's not irrational or resentful. It does not take rejoice at wrongdoing, but rejoices with truth. Love bears all things and believes all things and hopes all things, endures all things. Let me translate it in a different way. God is patient and kind. God never envies or boasts. You never hear God or Jesus walking about what I can do, what I can do. But the question is, what can I do for you? You see, God is not irritable or resentful. God is only upset when you go against Him, when you push Him to the wayside. If you were to take your wife or your daughter or your child and push Him to the wayside, then they will be resentful. Well, God is our Father. We can't push Him to the wayside. Love bears all things and believes all things. Throughout the Word, you hear Jesus loves us. He comforts what? Murderers. He comforts what? Drug abusers. He comforts what? Wife abusers. He comforts everybody. It doesn't matter how much money you owe. It doesn't matter what you've done in your life. God is there for you. He bears all. If you look at the word bear, it really means to cover, to hold. God Himself came onto this earth and bared our cross. That wasn't just a wooden thing that He carried on His back, but He carried our problems. He carried the debts that you owe to somebody. He carried the debts that you owe the government. He carried the debts that you did wrong to somebody. He took everything that's wrong with your life and said, I will take the blame and you just relax. Because God loves you. God loves everything. Love knows no bounds. If you have a child in jail, do you stop loving that child? If your child gets an F in their report card, do you hate that child? No. If your child has an accident and it's his fault in a car, do you stop loving that child? No. God loves us no matter what we've done. You see, we walk down the path and sometimes we leave God in the dust. God still loves us. But we have to remember, like I've told you before, let's stop looking in the rearview mirror and start looking ahead of us. God is on the side of that road waiting for us. He's our AAA. When we run out of gas, He's there. When we need a problem, He's there. Or when we have a problem, He's there. And sometimes we do need a problem. Because when we have a problem, we realize how powerful God is. When we have a problem, that gives us a reason to praise God. When we have a situation that's not in our control, that gives us a reason to say, God, take over. Because you see, when you're not in a situation that you can control, when you're in a situation that's beyond what you have to reach up. You don't ever reach down. You reach up to come out of the water. And God's hand is reaching down to grab you, to yank you out of that water, and to say, listen, son, I'm not going to let you suffer. But sometimes you have to stay in that water to know you're drowning. Sometimes you have to have a situation to remind you where you are. I've heard some people say that I didn't like prison, but I needed prison. I needed prison to remind me who I really am. I needed prison to let me know there are greater things than me. I needed prison to set my life straight. To know maybe my life isn't going the direction that it's supposed to go. And when God sees that you've already realized that, that's when He opens that door and says, walk this way. But again, you have to listen of the direction to go. Love knows no bounds. You see, just like an animal, you take a dog, he licks you and he jumps on you. And anything you do, you can go up in the morning or in the evening and kick that dog. Slam that dog, throw it about. 5 minutes later, you go, come here, boy. That boy, he's wagging his tail. He loves you. He does not have conditional love. He doesn't love you only when you feed him. He doesn't love you only when you pet him. He doesn't love you only when he wants to. He loves you all the time. God is the same way. He loves you all the time. God loves you when you're broken down. God loves you when you owe money. God loves you when someone's yelling at you. He has never put a condition on His love. But then comes the punishment. God says, if you don't believe in me and you don't follow me, this is what's going to happen to you. You see, I've heard people say, if God was a fair God, a just God, why does He let all these bad things happen? Well, I have the answer. So many times we say, God, take care of all the bad people. But let me tell you something. You might be one of the bad people He's going to take care of. Now, if you ask God right now to eliminate all the evil on this earth, you yourself might be eliminated. So ask yourself right now, is it the time to say, God, take care of all the bad things? I don't think so. Because every time you turn around, you were thinking a bad thought. You were doing a bad thing. And if God came right now and took care of business, trust me, you might be His business. So, what I'm trying to say, God is always there. He is a good God, but that's the reason He's a just God. If you were to go to a courtroom and you say, Judge, I know you're a good judge, and I'm really sorry for the crime I did. Let me go. Go. Now, if the judge says, I know that you're really sorry that you committed that offense. You're never going to do it again. But since I'm a judge, I have to be right, and I have to sentence you to be a good judge. The Lord is a good judge. He can't go back on His word, but He gave us Jesus. He gave us the Lord Jesus who took that punishment, so you don't have to take that punishment. What I'm trying to say, God loves you. He's given you a way out. If you owe money, sure, you're going to have to pay it sometime. But God's going to set you free. I have seen people in the jail set free. I've seen them locked up with chains, but they were really free. Nothing you could say to them would stop them from being free. Because you know why? God had set them free in that jail. It didn't matter their surroundings. God had set their heart free. And He can do that to you. As I get ready to close, I want you to know, to all that hear my voice today, God is love. And you need to ask yourself, what is love? Love is unconditional. No matter what you do or what you say, God will never leave you. He will never abandon you. He can heal you if you ask Him. He can give you things if you ask Him. But the thing is, you need to be asking Him to come in your heart first. If you want money to buy a house, you don't expect the bank just to walk up to you and say, here's some money, buy the house. You got to go to the bank and say, can I have some money? They may deny you, but you got to go there. They're not going to come to you and knock on your door and say, by the way, I heard through a friend of a friend that you were thinking of buying a house and here's some money. God's the same way. You got to look. God is looking for us. He's the Father that's kept the light on 24 hours. But you got to step up and go to the light. And the door is always open. So today, if you hear my voice and you're tired of the problems that you have and you're tired of the situations you've been in and you want to just say, I'm tired of it, Jesus is there for you. I'd like to say this prayer for you. Dear Lord, Father God, I ask you to bless all the people that hear my voice today. I ask you to touch those that need touching healing. Lord, I know there's someone here that's in pain, a physical pain. Well, they can't get up in the morning because the pain is so great. And the bills are piling up. And the kids are looking with wandering eyes. Lord, I ask you to give them strength today. I ask you to give strength for those that need it. And if you accept God into your heart today, you're saved. But as I said before, that's just the beginning. You need to reach up and read the Word every day and pick up the Word and look at it. The Word is the Bible, God's spoken Word. I've heard people say, I haven't heard Him before. Well, if you open up the Bible, you can see Him and hear Him speak volumes to your life. Lord, I ask you to touch them right now. I ask you to touch everybody here. I ask you to touch Sister Tina, that her hands and her body will heal, Lord. I ask you to take away the pain so she can go about her daily business and worship you with pain-free days. I ask you to help her whole family, Brother Tito, Kayla, Deja. I ask you to touch them. And Lord, I ask you to help and bless Sister Jackie and her mother who's going through problems, who has dialysis. But Lord, you can heal everything. I ask you to heal Brother Danny's wife of the emotional stresses that she goes through every day and the pains, and also Brother Danny as he has suffering. I ask you to look after Brother Micah and everyone here today. I ask you to bless them in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ.